personas are representations of our users. They promote empathy by allowing us to focus on individuals rather than groups. It's this whole issue of empathy. We keep talking about users and even just talking about the roles like customers or clerk or salesperson doesn't make these roles seem real. We're not talking about real people. Real people have limited abilities. Real people don't necessarily get computers in the same way that the development team does. Real people have needs that have been brought up by their circumstances or by their own personal beliefs. So we need to know a bit about them. And personas are a great way of representing those understandings in the design of a real system. So there is strong psychological evidence for personal bias. Our brains are wired to empathize with individuals rather than groups, and I will give you those references. This is something that Stalin said a long time ago, but it's not just Stalin. If one man dies of hunger, that is a tragedy. If millions die, that's only statistics. But we have other studies, which are much more recent than Joseph Stalin. But the general feeling is that when we dehumanize people by referring to them with these abstract collective nouns, because collective nouns are abstract by definition. So we're talking about users or we're talking about customers. We're taking the people away. We need to put the people back. Back in 1983, David Sears ran a study with two sets of participants. He gave the participants the same characteristics. And in one set of participants, he said that these characteristics were of an individual. And I believe he described the individual. And in the other set of participants, he said that these characteristics were of a group of people. And the participants who were told that they were seeing the characteristics of an individual always rated the individual more highly than the participants who rated the characteristics in connection with a group. So that he called the person positivity bias, and it basically is confirmation that our brains, us as individuals, prefer thinking about other individuals, certainly more inclined to think more positively about other individuals than we are about collective nouns like tourists or customers or users. The scope-severity paradox is a much more recent piece of work, 2010, and is quite surprising. Two researchers, Nordgren and McDonnell, established that reactions to a fraud were more severe when it was presented with three victims rather than 30. So it's the same kind of deal, two set of participants, both given exactly the same details of a crime, except that in one group they were told it affected three people, and the other group they were told it affected 30 people. And it was the people who were told that there were only three victims that thought that the crime was more severe. And they, on average, added a year on the prison sentence that the perpetrators of this crime should receive. So, again, that is just confirming this tendency for us to feel more strongly about individuals than we do about groups.